Well, he's got a big event coming up, and he is on to promote it with us today. We go live to our MGM Northfield Park hotline. David Njoku. David, Chief, what's up, Chief?
What's up, baby? How y'all doing?
Chief. David, what is the, first of all, softball. Now, are you a softball guy? You're doing a charity outing. And it is Saturday, June 8th, 2 p.m., inviting fans. It's in the afternoon, 2024 edition, guarantees an action-packed day, commencing with Home Run Derby at 4 o'clock, leading up to the main event, Celebrity Softball. Exclusive tickets for Captain's Passport members are available. However, anybody can come. Don't miss your opportunity. You're going to have a star-studded crew here. David, what made you want to do this?
I mean, honestly, when they reached out to me, I thought it was a great idea. You know, people think that I throw pretty good parties, so I see that as a compliment. And I feel like it's for a great cause. The great cause is, number one. Number two, I feel like the energy can be electric, especially with all the Dog Pound fans there. And I think it's going to be a great time for everybody.
Listen to this, guys. Pre-game home run won by Donovan Mitchell last year set the stage for an unbelievable game. Your teammates are going to be there. Myles Garrett, Kareem Hunt, Denzel Ward, Browns quarterback Bernie Kosar, Stipe. Is Travis Kelce coming, Ben, in this one?
You know, I actually just talked to him personally maybe like a week ago. He's going to try to. It's not confirmed yet, but, you know, knowing him, he has a very busy schedule. But he loves the city of Cleveland just like I do. But he's going to make a very strong attempt.
David, you really have. There was just a story I saw and a video I saw of you. And you were telling everybody, you have just fallen in love with Cleveland. How did that happen?
No, you know, the thing with love is it's never really planned, isn't it? You know, it just, you know, when it happens, it happens. And, you know, throughout the years, the ups and the downs, you know, I feel like the downs were also very important, just like the ups, you feel me? The relationship that the city and I acquired is second to none. So, you know, just becoming a man in this city, just seeing everything, just, you know, living life for the last 7 to 8 years in this city. Really changed my perspective on life, you know. I'm very appreciative. I'm very grateful for it all.
It's funny. You're talking about you asked for a trade and probably had plans of playing somewhere else. The Browns liked you so much, they said no and basically made you stay. But it happened for the best for everyone, didn't it, David?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, the thing with life is you always want to have control. You always want to have a grip on, you know, everything going on, you know. But at the end of the day, life is life. You know, God is in control at the end of the day. And, you know, it's up to us just to figure it out under his watchful eye.
David, what did you think when you saw that Tom Brady's first game broadcasting was going to be the Dallas Cowboys at the Cleveland Browns for the season opener, September 8th, 4:25 at Brown Stadium?
I mean, it's a bunch of emotions. Number one, having Tom Brady broadcast is obviously huge. Number two, you know, going against the Cowboys after, you know, a little friendly, you know, competition of, you know, words from me and Micah, you know, and just along with, you know, playing what is known to some people as America's team. It's all very exciting, you know, so, yeah, we cannot wait.
David, what was your reaction to the schedule overall? Do players even care? You know you're going to have to play Steelers, Bengals, Ravens twice. You know the teams that are coming here, the Chiefs and the Cowboys. You got some big-time players that you guys are playing against. What was your reaction yesterday, if anything?
Honestly speaking, you know, we obviously know a few teams that we play twice a year. And, you know, the other teams are also exciting, too. You know, for me, honestly, it doesn't really matter. I just want to play. It don't matter who it is. I want to get after it. I want to have some fun, get a little physical, you know, the whole shebang.
All right, here we go. Tickets are at captainsbaseball.com to secure your exclusive ticket and be part of the excitement. It's captainsbaseball.com. The event is Saturday, June 8th at 2 o'clock. Gates will open. Home run derby followed by the game itself. Now, David, we have our own – this show is so huge. We have our own movie critic, and he comes on every week. He told me that you're in a movie with Harvey Keitel. Is that correct?
Yeah, Harvey Keitel, Tyree, Danny Trejo, a bunch of other cats. We filmed it last year. I believe it should be in theaters at some point this year. I thought it was going to be in March, but I guess this, with the editing, it's still taking time. So,
what did you? Who did you play? What part did you play? A badass?
Man, you're going to have to watch it and find out, I guess.
How fun was it? Did you enjoy it?
It was a fun time. Yeah, it was a fun time. The crowd was awesome. Everybody was very friendly, you know, loving. So, yeah, we made a great time out of it.
David, will you weigh in? All the athletes are having this NFL v. NBA debate right now. You know, football players could play basketball. Mm. Basketball players could play football.
No, they can't.
Do you buy this notion that, you know, like could you go play in the NBA now if you wanted? And do you think there are guys in the NBA that could pretty much step right into training camp and be professional football players?
I think neither, honestly. You know, I understand this the sport that I play myself and NFL players play, you know, it's a sport that we've been training nonstop, you know, for a very long time, vice versa, you know what I mean? It's not just, you know, let me hop in and see what I can do. It's very, 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 very strategic. There's very, very little things for error. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So I don't think either can play professionally. I'm sure that I can play basketball in a pickle game in my backyard. But in terms of professionally, I think it's a bit more serious than that.
Absolutely. I don't think there's any kind of debate to that, David, at all. Are you guys over the Houston debacle the last season, that ended last season yet?
Say that one more time.
Are you guys over that last game in the playoff loss to Houston yet? Did you put it behind you?
I mean, it's behind us by force, but it's not forgotten. You know what I mean? Houston played a tremendous game against us, and I hope to see them again soon.
I like that. You're looking for a little revenge, huh?
I mean, it's never personal, but sometimes it is personal.
Sure.
You get me?
Sure. David, is there an opponent you like to play more than others? I mean, do you guys look forward to our division games more, or do you have close?
Yeah, honestly speaking, I hate to admit, but just playing the Ravens, I just love playing the Ravens. It's just, you know, they're such a great, great high-energy team. You know, it's always a big commotion when we play them. So that's usually one of my favorites.
Well, you got them the last game of the year this year. This is week 18. They haven't announced the time or the day yet. That could be a Saturday or a Sunday game. What kind of mode are you in right now? I see video of you working. How many hours a day you work out?
Honestly, anywhere from like 6 to 9 hours, you know, including PT work and everything. It's a full job.
Wait, 6 to 9 hours a day. No wonder you look like that.
Yeah, I'm also with a bunch of jeans that God blessed me with. It's
you
hard
do,
to really
yeah.
Over here.
Yeah, you got some good jeans.
David, when you're here, can I go do the 6 to 9 hours? I want to know how long I could hang before I just fell over dead.
I'd give you 45 minutes. I've seen his workouts. I've seen his workouts. I don't think you could last a half hour.
If you want to test it.
Yeah, I do. I want to. Is it cardio? Is it weightlifting? It's all of the above.
David,
right?
You better have an ambulance waiting over there if this guy's going to do that.
You're going to have to sign a couple contracts before you do anything. So.
Yeah, that's right. David.
Three to five contracts before you partake, and then you can have a great time with me.
How excited are you with the Browns now in Africa? The NFL has partnered up overseas. Explain to everybody what that means, and when's the last time you've been over there? I think Nigeria.
Yeah. So the Browns, we took over Nigeria for the NFL Global Market Program.
Right.
That, you know, in terms of media, we have full access to go, you know, back and forth, you know, to use them, to utilize them, and vice versa. I think this is huge. I'm going back to Nigeria in June. We're trying to do a few camps out there. I believe Burner Boy a big-time musician out there. He's going to be hands-on in a couple of other camps. You know, this will really be huge for us in terms of just, you know, opening up a bridge, you know, in terms of talent and in terms of marketing. So, yeah, I'm very excited. I think this is amazing for us and Nigeria as well.
David, you're explaining to everybody, you're like royalty, right? You are a legitimate chief. I know the chief is your nickname, but explain, you know, your heritage.
Yeah, so I was inaugurated, or I had my chieftaincy, rather, a couple of years ago. We pretty much just, you know, just building the responsibility of holding it down. Oh, in my home country, you know, so for me, it's a very, very, very great honor. You know, as Nigerians know, the word chief, the name chief, it doesn't just come with just a name. It comes with, you know, like a big, strong title as well. So I'm just blessed to be where I am. You know, I owe it all to God. I cannot take any credit. It's all God's work, and we are just beginning.
Well, I got to tell you, you have matured so much. David, I know you're not going to ever complain, but you came here when you were 20 years old, like 21 years old.
Yeah, into that had not won a game.
Yeah, and you were one of the youngest rookies we've ever had here. I mean, how difficult was that, and how far do you feel like you have come now?
We've come a long way, you know, from 20 years old to 27. A lot happened in life, especially, you know, personal and in the professional world, you know. So different perspectives occur, you know, throughout the years. Different things change. And I just got to say, I'm just blessed to be where I am today. Like I said earlier, I owe it all to God, you know, but we are far from done. We didn't get this far just to get this far. You understand me? So that being said, go Browns. Let's have a great time. Let's keep working. We're not done yet.
You guys feel like you're on a roll, David? I feel like the team has come together like never before, at least since you've been here. Have you ever been with a tighter-knit group than what you guys have right now?
Thus far, no. I have to say that we definitely took it upon ourselves to bring this group tighter and get closer and learn more about each other, personal standpoint and a professional standpoint. You know what I mean? With that being said, players I've never seen that they're not just playing for themselves or for their own personal accolades. It's more so for the family that we've built together, the team that we've put together. And when players play in that type of perspective, the sky is literally the limit.
David, you've made some incredible plays in your career, but the thing I think about you first is the fact that you were in that incident and that you came and played that week in the game after dealing with the burn. Why was that so important to you to be out there that Sunday when probably every doctor on the staff was telling you that it may not be the best idea?
Yeah, I'm not going to lie to you. From the head trainer, Joe Sheehan, to all our doctors, they told me that I was not going to be able to play. So I looked him in the eye and I told him, listen, man, it's either I play with or without you. So if I play without you, I'm going to get more, you know, probably hurt. So it's best that you help me play and, you know, that's it and shut up. So, no, I mean, number one, it was Ravens week, so it was obviously personal before it even started. Number two, honestly speaking, I wanted to see how far I could push myself, you know, that the saying in the Bible that flesh is weak, definitely played a big thing in this story because the flesh is weak, you know what I mean? And at the end of the day, the mind or the body will follow the mind, whatever the mind is going to do.
Yeah.
And the mind told myself that I was going to play, and that's exactly what I did.
Yeah.
But honestly, more than expected.
Yeah. That's real stuff, isn't it? Tell everybody, man, when you realize that stuff that they say and it really happens to you, that's got to be exhilarating, David.
No, it was a rush. The adrenaline was amazing, second to none. So I probably would have done it again if given a chance.
All right. Here we go. June 8th. 2 p.m., celebrity softball. Who is the opponent this year?
I mean, really, it's a bunch of cats from all over the country, even out of the country. You know, I never expected people to be flying from out of the country to Cleveland, Ohio. You know, that's not really heard of often. So the fact that we were able to make this work was huge for us, you know. So I believe the rosters are out right now. You know, we still have a couple other cats that are coming that's not even on the roster that signed up late. So we're excited, man. We're really excited to get this going. I know it's going to be a high energy situation. I cannot wait to see all the fans there. I need all the fans, as many as I can come there, because they fuel us to have an even more fun time. You know what I mean?
Yes. David, how's Deshaun look? Is he all right?
keep looking good, baby. Getting better every day. And that's all we can ask for.
Yeah. I'll bet you guys are excited to get him in there and get – hey, listen, God bless. Stay healthy, man. That's what I tell all the athletes that come on our show. As long as you stay healthy, I know you guys are going to be great. We – you know, we had a tough one last year, David. We had a lot of people go down, so we're due for a good year. We get some good karma going from the Lord. How's that?
Hey, God is good, man, but no promises. It's up to God for us to stay healthy, isn't it?
You're staying healthy this year, damn it.
David, are you guys, offense doing a trip this year? Where are you guys going? Puerto Rico? What's the story?
We haven't decided yet. We still got time, especially with, you know, some of the players' pockets there. They definitely don't mind booking a last-minute trip. So, we'll see. We're going to gather together and have a little couple meetings, you know, see what we can do and go from there.
David, always a pleasure. Good luck at the event. Let us know if you need anything else. They'll promote it, okay?
Thank you guys so much. I appreciate it.
You got it. You got it, Chief. Talk to you later. And Njoku!